namaha hari om narayanam namaskritya naram chaiva narottamam devim saraswatim vyasam tato jayamudirayet shruti smriti purananam alayam karunalayam namami bhagavat pada shankaram loka shankaram shankaram shankaracharyam keshavam badarayanam sutra bhashya krito vande bhagavando punah punah Sri Ganesh Sharada Gurubhyo Namaha Eko Naikah Savakkim Ekaha Sajatiya Vijatiya Swagada Bheda Vinirmuktatvat Ekaha. The word Ekaha means the Samaveda Chandogya Upanishad. It says Ekameva Dvitiyam. Ekam means not two. Ekam eva, there is only one. Adhutiyam, there is no dhutiyam, there is no dhutiyam vastu. Madhvacharya also says that Harireva sarvam, all that is only Hari. So that Ekam is Vishnu, sarvam Vishnu. That is not enough. That is not enough to say that He is one. You also have to add, there is nothing else. That is why simply one is not enough. That is why he is quoting that. Ekam eva, none else. Everything else comes and goes. Nad dvitiyam. What is this dvitiyam? Dvitiya means division. Dvitiya means the second one. Why not the second one? Why there shouldn't be a second one? Because bheda vinirmuktatvat. It is mukta. Vishnu is mukta. Vishnu is free from Bheda. In Bhagavatam, they have the definition of mukti. Muktistektva anyatha rupam. Mukti means anyatha rupam tektva. You give up your false form. Swasurupena avasthitihi. And you be in your own true surupam. That is called mukti. Right now you are not in your true surupam. When you become a mukta, you attain your own real rupam. That is called swarupam. So he is also like that, who Vishnu. Vishnu never got into samsara in the first place. That is why he is called vinirmukta. We will become mukta one day. But in the case of Vishnu, they have put two prefixes to mukti. What are the two prefixes? We and me. Nishesham. Never there was a problem of not being free. Always free. And visheshena. That is why vinirmuktaha. So what is that we and me? Bheda. Nishesena, free from what? That is what I am asking. Utterly free from what? What is Vishnu free from utterly? From Bheda. From division. So when you look at this table, you see a white color. You also see the beige. White is Shweta. Shvetatva Jatiman. It belongs to the species of whiteness. It is something which has whiteness in it. And the beige color is Pitaha. Pitatva Jati Man. So there are two jatis in Rupa. And among the Rupa, there is Pita Rupa and Shukla Rupa. Shuklatvam and Pitatvam is called Sajatiya Bhedam. Everybody is a human, but one is man, one is woman. One is a physician, one is an engineer. So inside the species, inside the human species, you have divisions. White, black. So all this is called Sajadiya Bheda. If inside the species you have got Bheda, that is called Sajadiya Bheda. But when you treat human and a tree and an animal, that is Vijadiya Bheda. Yeah. These both kinds of Bhedas are not never in Vishnu. He can never have Bheda. What is the problem with this Bheda? why does they say that Mukti is giving up Anya Rupam? This Veda, giving up this Veda and Sosurupa and Avastana Muktihi. Why is it so important that you give up this Veda? Because Vedam creates fear. Vedam creates fear. Harir Bhutva Harim Yajet. Before doing puja to Hari, you have to become Hari. Hari means Chaitanyam. Hari means pure awareness. You have to think that you are awareness. You should not think that I am Tom, Dick and Harry wanting something. I have a problem. Solve this. That should not how you should worship. You should think that you are Chaitanyam. From that standpoint, you have to, that is your Surupam. But when you compromise that and give up that, then you have created Bedam in you. Whenever you are at home, whenever you are peaceful, whenever you are happy, you have become one with that object. And when you are not one with that, then there is doubt, then there is division, then there is pain. Edudaram antaram kurute atha tasya bhayam bhavati. Yet that which person ut means little bit, ut means a little bit, aram means in Malayalam ara, in Tamil ara means half, so whole is cut into half, that's what ara. So aram means bhagam. When you cut it, aram kurute, when you do that, bhayam bhavati, immediately there is fear. So if it is a joint family, then there is no aram. Then you break it, then there is fear. Fear is always caused by the other. When there is no other, there is no fear. Whom do you fear? You fear the other person. But if the person does not have otherness in him, if the other person does not have otherness, then you are not creating aram. Then you are fused with that. Then there is no fear. That is why Bhedam is the cause of Bhayam. All this Ajnanam is caused because of division. Naturally, you looked at it. When you look at the table, you don't say beach, white table. You don't say that. You just say, what do you see? Table. There is the beige and the white color in it. But you ignore that completely. In your perception, why? Because who is reporting this table to you? Who is telling that there is a table here? Your eye is telling you. And the eye does not have a mind of its own. Atma manasa sinyujyate mana indriyena indriyamarthena tadah pratyaksham utpadyate. Whenever you are perceiving this world, pratyaksham is because of senses. And the senses are dumb. They don't have any thoughts. I just reports. It collects data and gives it to you. It doesn't want to divide. It presents the wholesome world unto you. That wholesome world is Vishnu. Actually, the eye is presenting Vishnu to you. So I presented Vishnu to the mind. And mind, the table became occupied in the mind. And the table reports to you. You means who? Ahankara. That I am the separate entity. I am the Swami. I am the great one. Ishwaroham aham bhogi siddhoham balavan sukhi. That ego gets reported. And ego makes the decision. Ego comes to a conclusion. This is my table. That is your table. You keep yours. I keep mine. Then there is fear. When will I lose it? Will it remain here? But if you let the ego not to conclude, just by seeing, it is not the ego which possesses this thing. Ego is not the possessor. Entire thing is possessed by Hari. The entire thing belongs to Hari. When you see that, there is no aram. That is why we should not just say Vishnu is one. We should say there is only Vishnu. Because if you accept a second thing other than Vishnu, then there is problem. That can cause a fear in you. That is why he is saying, Ekah means not just one, but none else. That meaning is also brought out. The Shruti itself, Veda itself brings that. Okay, now the question is, if that is the case, why are we not seeing the whole thing? If everything is Vishnu, Vishnu is the only present thing, why am I seeing white, black and all these differences in the world? What is prompting? He's saying, Paramarthataha. You don't have that. That's the first line, first word. Paramarthataha sajadiya vijadiya swagada bheda vinirmuktatvat. So he is Paramatma and he has got the Paramarthata. Paramarthata means Paramaprayojanam, the ultimate reality. So in reality there is no bhedam. And you have to have his grace to get into that, his reality. So the people always say, you don't understand me. I have been living with you for 20 years. Your reality is different from my reality. Why? You can understand my reality. Why should I understand yours? That will be the other counterpart argument. So we have this fragmented realities for each and every human. And when you leave this place, another person will take your position and he will have his own reality. Definitely he will not agree with your theories. So this is what we are living in. Our experience in reality is fragmented. Why? Because we let the ego decide and conclude. He concluded, I am the chairman, he sat. That's it. Until nobody questions, that ego sits right there. Nobody can ask. You will keep on arguing for 25 years. You see my way. And you will get back, right back. No, you see my way. And this fragmented reality is called Vyavaharyam. What is it called? Transactional. In transaction, there is always a father, a parent, a child, and the friend. The friend has no problem. You don't have to fight with him for 20 years. Immediately, he'll accept you as you are. That is why he's your friend. You pat his back, he will pat your back. That is why this is called a transaction. And with the person who is claiming superiority, you act as though you are inferior for the time being to get the thing done. All these divisions is very crude. Why? Because it is not your nature. Why? Paramarthataha, you are one. You are not a divided individual. You are bheda rahitaha. You don't have any bheda at all. You are a complete wholesome person. That is your truth. That is your tat tvam. That is why he says paramarthataha ekam. Means what? Aparamarthataha. Means vivahartaha. In the transactional word, it is not. All you will find is bhedam. That is why we should chant this. Ekah. Always remind yourself that there is only one. In fact, when there is a fight, there is two. And when you become, the fight becomes resolved, it becomes, then there is no problem. The subject and object has become resolved into one. We will say our family. When it is dysfunctional, you are different from me. You are Pandava. I'm sorry, you are Kaurava and I am Pandava. Always. It's always like that. You are Kaurava and I am Pandava. But when you become one, you will say we are all Dhartarashtras. We are all Shantanu's family. So this is the play that always happens in Vyavahara. That is why we have to eschew difference. Difference can cause fear. And difference is natural. If you don't examine your life, if you don't have therapy, you will be divided. So that is called Paramarthataha. Paramarthataha sajatiya vijatiya swagada bheda. Swagada bheda means even in oneself there can be bheda. Morning you can be one person, evening you can be another. There are several divisions in you. Edat sarvam nasti Vishnu iti bheda vinirmuktaha. Nirmuktam nityamuktam. Vinirmukta of all bhedas. Okay, what are the causes of divisions? Another one thing is desataha, kalataha, vastutaha. These are the causes of division again. That also is not present in Vishnu. You cannot find the desha where Vishnu is not. You go to Patala, he is there with Mahabali. He said that to Mahabali, he promised when he pushed him down, I will be always pratyaksha for you. Says in the Bhagavatam. Nobody got that, only Mahabali got it. 24/7 I will be looking at you and you can see me. Not only I will be seeing you can see me. He gave that. So he is there in Patala, in the whole Bhuvana, and there is no desha where Vishnu is not. So deshadaha parichedo nasti. If you are in this room and if you are in that room, you are parichinna in this place. Vishnu does not have that problem. Hence he is vinirmuktaha. That's why he is ekaha. So sajatiya, get all these words. Vijatiya, swagata, bheda, vi, nir, muktatvat, paramarthataha, ekaha. Then why these two? Because aparamarthataha, vyavahartaha. Now he says that whatever you give me all this lecture of oneness, I really don't get it. Then he says, Naikaha. Okay, that is fine. Vishnu is also Anekaha. Vishnu is Ekaha, Vishnu is Anekaha. How did it become Aneka? Mayaya. Because of his Maya. You accept that. So there was this Narada who went to this Vaikuntha and said, I have a Sangeet, you know, Harinama Sangeetanam. Musicians, they are extremely committed to you. Whenever they sing, I feel that Vishnu has to go there. And Vishnu said, no, they are not ripe. Give them some time. Let them do little more Sankirtanam. No, you have to come today. And he takes Vishnu there. And he introduces him to the head of the Sankirtanam party. And he says, this is Mahavishnu. Oh, that is a nice fancy dress. So he doesn't want to believe. So Vishnu says, see, I told you, they cannot recognize me. Even if I show myself up, they will think that he is something else, he is Anekaha. There are so many people who is doing fancy dress. This is good, but I have seen better. That's what he is saying, the devotee. Then he says, no, you don't worry, he is like, he doesn't really know, so you have to help him. So they play this mridangam. And for adjusting the mridangam, sometimes they keep a hammer or they keep a stone. They keep a stone. So he said, you turn that stone into gold, I'll believe you. When Narada pleads to him that he's real Vishnu. Oh, if he's Vishnu, he can turn the stone into gold. And he gives him the stone. The Vishnu touches and it becomes gold. All the people in the hall went out and got rocks. Give me one gold. So that is why he is Naikaha. That is because of his Maya.
Yes, it is.
Even though you have Vishnu right here, you don't get it. Why? Mama Maya Duratyaya. My Maya is very hard to cross over. This ignorance is very nibida. It has a very ancient history. So it's not just going to go away with one single stroke. It'll take time. Or Mamevaye prapadyante mayam etam tarandite. If you just do saranagati, mam ekam saranam raja, if you see me as one without any division, then I can free you. That is why he is Naikaha. Mayaya bahurupatvat. Because of his maya, he can become, he will agree that he is a fancy dress Vishnu. If you want him that way. Iti Naikaha. For this also there is a Shruti. Indro Maya Vipururupa Iyate. It is the same Paramatma Pururupaha. Purum Pura means your body. In every body, as multitude of forms, he is the one. It is the same Paramatma. So earlier the Shruti said Paramartata Ekam. Now he is saying Maya Anekam. Maya is Vivahara, your transactional reality. That is Maya. Iti Brihadaranyaka Shrutehe. So Ekaha, Naikaha. The third one is Savaha. Savaha is the name of a yaga. What is Sava? Sava means Satram. Satra means Yagam. Yagam means Yajnam. But what is the difference between yajna and sava? In sava, suyate, there is squeezing done. In a yaga where there is squeezing done, squeezing of what? Of somalata. So savaha means somayagaha. It's a ritual conducted in somayaga. So savaha means yagaha. Where soma is suyate, squeezed. And that somayaga is what? Vishnu. So after all this Narada's compromises, still these people want many. They don't want the single happiness. They want heavenly happiness. And to get heaven, you have to do somayaga. Surgakama somena yajeta. That's what the Veda says. If you are a surgakama, if you want to take that Florida trip, then sacrifice. Do this extensive ritual. It takes 12 years to learn 3 Vedas. And to understand the mantras in the somayaga. Do all that, then you will get savaha. You will become a surgiya. You will get surga. That is why he is saying savaha. So first choice is, you remain undivided and one. Then you are ekaha. Then you want that golden rock. You become naikaha. Then what is the way for sukham? If you want to live in a divided world, how do you get sukham? By savaha, by sacrifice. Unless you do punyam. Tetam bhuktva punya lokam visalam. Sorgam is punya lokam. Sorgam is got punya lokam. That punya lokam cannot be attained without punyam. And what is punyam? Punyam means sitting quietly in the class for 1 hour. What is that? Punyam. You have to sacrifice. Punyasya phalam ichanti. Punyam ne chanti manavaha. Punyasya phalam is Mercedes. Everybody wants that. But they don't want to do punyam. What is punyam? Hard work. Exertion. It's not easy. Punyam is not easy. But punya phalam will be very... That is why everybody wants that. Without the punyam, they want the phalam. And that is savaha. Yajnaha is punyam. Yajnaha is way to swargam. And that is also Vishnu. That is also Vishnu. That is why ekaha, naikaha, savaha. So what is he really? Kaha. What is he? Kaha. Actually, it is a Napumsakalinga shabda. Napumsakalinga means neutral gender. So it is kam. Eko ne ka savaha kam. Kam means sukham. The meaning of kam is sukham. Shankara writes. So last words, what did he say? So adhvaraha savaha. Adhvaraha means yagaha. So savaha means adhvaraha yagaha. The next one is ka shabdaha sukha vachakaha. Kaha means sukha vachakaha. Kaha means sukham. Kam means sukham. But because it is Vishnu, they transformed it into pullinga. How can you transfer that? Because there is a Paniya Sutra. Acharat kaha quip. There is a quip pratyaya. When you act, that is achara, then you can get that pratyaya. So Vishnu is always happy. He shows how to be happy by being happy. So his achara is what? Sukham. Hence, kam becomes kaha. That is a grammatical transformation. You don't have to really know that. But if you ask why comes Nabumska became kaha, that is because of this quip which was given by Panini.
Kaha is not Brahmaji?
Yeah. That's what the Chandogya Upanishad says. Look at there. Kam Brahma. What is kam? So what is the next word?
Kim.
Kam Brahma. No, not Kim.
Come.
Yeah, that's what you are saying, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what he says. Kam Brahma. Then what? What does he say? Tena stuyate iti kaha. Brahmana stuyate. Brahma is coming and worshipping who? Vishnu. Iti saha kaha. Brahmaji is ka. Okay. Kasme deva yahvisha vidhema. That is Brahma Sukta. Kasme deva yahvisha. Kasme means Brahmane. Not for whom, there. Ka means Brahma. Kam Brahma. And Brahmaji does totra for whom? For Vishnu. For Paramatma. It is the same Paramatma who becomes the Trimurtis. And these Paramatma are also looking up at Parameshwara. The Trimurtis are also looking up at Parameshwara. That's what he says. Kashabdaha Sukavajaha. Kam means Sukham. Tena Stuyate iti Kaha. Sukhena Stuyate or Brahmana Stuyate. One who is being worshipped happily by Brahmaji. Kam Brahma. Okay, now, it is a little bit confusing probably because he says kam is sukham and kam is brahma. Okay, now you have to understand what is sukham. Once you understand what is sukham, you will understand why it is brahma. What is sukham? What is happiness?
Lack of pain and happiness.
That is Buddhist. Dukkha dhvamsaha, right? See, you have to dismiss all the possibilities. Then at the end you get, that is the thing. For us, it is called anukulataya vedaniyam. Whatever is acceptable, that is happiness. Why it is acceptable? Because that is your sarupa. You are happiness. So you cannot stand even a second of unhappiness. You only own what is your own. So what is happiness? Anukulataya vedaniyam. Vedani means understanding, receiving with no resistance at all. So non-resistant acceptance, that is called as happiness. Because in unhappiness, there is resistance. When you are unhappy, you say, I don't want it. The 10th idli is painful. 9 idlis are okay. But the 10th one becomes unacceptable. But you are never unacceptable. You will never say, I have got 10 minutes of myself. You can say to me, oh, I have got 1 hour of this lecture enough. You can say that. But you can never say to yourself, I am tired of myself. Who says that in this world? Why? Because you are sukham. You are what? Sukham means what? Always acceptable. What is the definition of sukham? Anukulataya vedaniyam. Aham ad anukulaha. I am always my own anukula. What is anukula? Kulam means bank. River bank. What is kulam? The actual word of kulam means what? Bank. Anukulam means, anu means underneath. After. Below. Anu means below. That's why you say anuja. Anuja is always after. You know that DW and Arthur, they have arguments. DW says that you are always going to be 3.5 years older to me. I never get to, because she is Anuja. So that is the meaning of Anu. Anu means under. So when the water is under the bank, that is called Anukulam, Anukula Nadi. But when it breaks the bank, it becomes Pratikulam. And that is dukkham. When it breaks it, that is pratikulam. So that is the nature of sukham. And what is that sukham? You are that. Who is sukham? Because you are never unacceptable to yourself. Others are unacceptable to you. But you yourself are never unacceptable. That is why you are kam. You are kam. That is why Vishnu is kam. Vishnu is always acceptable. Nobody is going to say no to Vishnu. They might call him with another name, Allah or Jehovah, whatever name they want to call, they can call it. But they are always just like you are acceptable, Vishnu is always acceptable because he is Sukham. And Sukham is never unacceptable. That's why he is going through this merry-go-round. You have to understand all these words. Kashabdaha Sukha Vachakaha Tena Stuyate Iti Kaha Kam Brahma. And that Kam is Atma. Kam is you. It is Srutehe. So, Ekaha, Naikaha, Savaha, Kam. See, this Kam means Sukham. Kam means Sukham. Sukham means you. But when you don't accept it, then you do the somayaga. When you don't understand that, then you have to go and do the somayaga. That's why it's slowly coming. Naikaha, savaha, you do punyam, then come, you get sukham. You really don't have to do punyam if you understand it to begin with. In the beginning, if you understand that you are one, you are not divided, then you don't have to get into this problem. The story of Kushwant Singh. The Sardarji is sitting in the farm, counting the stars. So the neighbor comes, hey, what are you doing here? I'm going to college. Don't you want to come? No. I'm okay. So come. I'm acceptable as I am. Then I'm just asking you, what will you do after college? I'll become a physician. Then I'll earn millions. Then I'll retire. And then I'll count the stars. That's what I'm doing. So if you understand in the beginning, then you don't have to go through that punyam because you are come. But you won't understand that you are sukham if you don't ask kim. That's what is next. Unless you do vichara. Unless you do vichara, that's why he says, ekaha, naikaha, savaha, kam, kim. So what does Shankara writes for kim? Let us see. Vicharyam iti brahma kim. Go and do vichara of what is Atma. Why? Sarva purushartha rupatvat. Because that is the real purushartha. What is purushartha? Purushasya prayojanam. Artham means what? Goal. Artham means prayojanam. Artham means purpose. Everybody is after what? That's sukham. Everybody wants to sit and count the stars. That's what everybody is after. Without any hassle. They want to sit and enjoy. That enjoyment is called purushartha. And that purushartha is sukham, Vishnu. But he says, though Vishnu or happiness is purushartha, vicharyam, you cannot just get it like that. By my statement, you won't get it. You have to do your own vichara. You need to do jijnyasa, inquire and understand. When I say that Brahma vichara, there is just jnana. I am reading the book to you. But when you know it as a fact, as anubhava, then it becomes your own. And that between that anubhava and this, between that vijnana and this jnana, the bridge is vichara. Unless you do vichara, you don't get there. That is why Shankara says, sarva purushartha rupatva, because this purushartha, human goal is happiness. Tat brahmaiva, that is Vishnu. Tat vicharyam. Hence, do Vishnu vichara. Do Brahma vichara. Do Atma vichara. Iti Brahma kim. And how do you do vichara? Kim. What it is? Kim. You do that. And that vichara is also Vishnu. You are asking kim, kim. That is Vishnu. There is somebody called Kim, right? Vishnu is also called Kim. Vishnu is Kim. Eko naika sabha kim. The next one is Yat. Oh, sorry. He is also quoting the Bhagavad Gita. In the Bhagavad Gita, he says, Kim tad brahma kimadhyatmam. This is how you do that inquiry. Krishna shows that to Arjuna. Kim tad brahma. What is that Brahman? Who is Vishnu? Kim adhyatmam? Who are this Atma? Who is this? You have to inquire. That's what Shankara says. Vicharyam. Kim iti vicharyam. So that Kim is done. Next one is Yat. What is the next one? Eko naika savakakim Yat. The next one is Tat. So Yat and Tat. They are the next two ones. Whenever you say yet, it is like a conditional clause. You have to say tat. Yatra yatra raghu nama kirtanam tatra tatra kritamastak yatra dhumaha tatra vannihi. When you say yet, you have to say tat. It is a conditional clause. And you can never say yet if you don't know the stuff. You can never say that without knowing it. An unknown thing cannot be spoken by this conditional clause. What is the conditional clause? That which is. That which. Yatra tatra yattador nitya sambandha. That is a Panini law. What is the law? What is the niyama? Yattador nitya sambandha. Yat and tat is eternally connected. So, and that yat shabda, that pronoun, because pronoun always stands for a noun, you have to know the noun. Then only you can use that yat. That's what Shankara is saying. Yat shabdena, by the conditional clause that, shabdena means by that shabda, by that sound, that, sodha siddha vastu, uddeshya vachina, brahma nirdishyate. You have to already understand what it is. It is svata siddham. Everybody knows what that yath is. How do you know? He says, yatova imani bhutani jayante. Yataha imani bhutani jayante. From that, all these bhutas came. Even in the Vishnu Sahasranama. Yatas sarvani bhutani bhavantyadi yugagame yasmimscha pralayam yanti punareva yugakshaye yasmin. So you know that. From which that Vishnu. So that yath is also Vishnu. So yachabdena svatasiddha vastu uddeshya vachana brahma nirdishyate. By yet this brahma is being told. Nirdishyate means being told. How do you know what is brahma? Svatasiddha. Everybody knows who he is. Anybody has a doubt that he is sitting here? You can never have that doubt. Even if you have amnesia. Others will have a doubt whether you have a doubt. But I would say, you will always know who you are. It is something pending understanding for the modern science. It is the subject always knows himself. Why? Svaprakashakatvat. You are always illumined by yourself. Nobody comes and tells you are there. In fact, they ask you, count this. They ask you. So they have doubt on you. But you never have doubt on yourself. You don't have to prove anything to anybody. Because you are self-referral consciousness. What are you? Self-referral consciousness. That's what they say. Svataha siddhaha. You are svata siddhaha. That's why you are talked by this word yet. That which you know it. It's famous. You are famous. Like they say in America, in the new world, you are famous. In your own world, you are always known. That's what he says. Svata siddha vastu. The object that is always siddham. Available. Tad brahma nirdishyate yat shabdena. That is the meaning of yat shabda. And he quotes the sruti to substantiate, saying that yatova imani bhutani jayante iti srute.
Where is this from? Which?
Ayurveda. Does it not say there?
It just says shruti.
Oh. No, for me it says Taittiriya Upanishad 3.1.
Yeah, it says
yeah.
Oh. Okay. So it's a different copy, yeah. So it says Taittiriya Upanishad, Tai U, meaning Yajurveda. In Yajurveda, there are two Upanishads. In Yajurveda, there is Katho Upanishad and Taittiriya Upanishad. There is one more Upanishad called Mahanarayan Upanishad. That is in the Yajurveda, but Shankara did not comment on it. So we don't say anything. Shankara commented only on Katha and Shankara, Ramarja, Madhva, Nimbar, Kavallabha, everybody commented on only these two. Taittiriya and Katha. So this is from the Taittiriya Upanishad. Yatova imani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti yat prayanda visambishanti ti tad vijijnyasasva tad brahmeti satapotapyata satapastaptva idagum sarvamasrajata. So like that it goes. So that jijnyasa has to be done. This is the exact same verse in Vishnu Sahasranama. Yatova imani yato yatas sarvani bhutani bhavantyadiyugagame yasmimsya pralayam yanti punarevayugakshaye. Exact same meaning. So you cannot say from whom the entire world came unless you know what it is, what you are talking about. When you say from whom the entire world came, you really know what you are talking about. You might not know whether he is wearing Pidambaram or Neelambaram today. That you might have a doubt. But you don't have a doubt that it is him. You might have a doubt in the details. But you definitely know it is from Vishnu. So already we have set up so much and got so much Shraddha. No, don't say that I don't know. At least protect me. And agree that you are knowing what I am saying. So that is Yate. And what is...
Imani?
Huh? Imani? Imani means this. Yeah. So famous shampoo. Imani. Anyway, imam, ime, imani.
Cream, face cream.
Yeah, yeah, cream, cream. Okay. Close enough. Imam, ime, imani. Like, it's like the pronoun. Imani means this. It always qualifies a noun. So they are saying imani bhutani. Imani bhutani means anybody who is using imani will become like a bhutam. All these creatures. Imani bhutani means all these creatures. The next one is tate. What is the next one? Yet tate. Ekah, naikah, savah, kakim, yet tat padamanuttamam, yet tate. What is tate? Tate means tanoti. Tanoti means maketh. Biblical language. One who makes. One who makes is called tate. Tatati, tanoti. One who makes. So means creator. That is Brahma. Brahma tanoti iti tat. One who creates, so he is called tat. What's the meaning of tanoti? Vistranati. One who spreads out. That is what he is. The entire creation he spreads out. He rolls it out like that. That is why he is called as tat. How do you know that tat is Brahma? Who told you? If you ask Shankara, he says, Krishna told me, Bhagavad Gita, 17th chapter, 23rd verse, Om Tat Sat Iti Nirdeshat Brahmana Trividasmritaha. There are three names for Brahman. Brahman has three names. The first name of Brahman is Om. What is the meaning of Om? Brahma. The second name of Brahma is Tat. Tat Tomasi. Brahma Tomasi. Tat means Brahma. Om Tat. And the third name of Brahma is Sat. That is why whenever you end any ritual, Om Tat Sat. That is like Brahmarpanam. When you say Om Tat Sat, you are recognizing. What does Arpanam mean? Arpanam means recognition. And as a token, you give a flower. But even if you don't give that flower, it is that recognition which makes it Arpanam. So at the end, you always say this. What do you say? Om Tat Sat. And this is called Brahmanaha Nirdeshaha. Nirdesha means recognition. Telling. Om Tat Sat is the recognition of Brahma. And it can be done in this Trividaha. With this three ways. With these three names. That's what Krishna says. It is Smritaha. Smritaha means Smriti. Bhagavad Gita is a Smriti. So
Brahma here is, you're talking about Chaturmukh. Brahma.
No. Yeah, entire. Yeah. Brahmaji. Yeah. Durga Brahma will always have a Virga. Virga means what? Pullinga. Brahma, Brahmanu, Brahmanaha. Brahmanam, Brahmanu, Brahmanaha. Brahmana, Brahmabhyam, Brahmabhi. Like that. This one is Brahma, Brahmani, Brahmani. Brahma, Brahmani, Brahmani. Like that. So this is Brahma. That is Brahma. So Om Tat Sat Iti Nirdeshat Brahmanaha. This Brahman means Paramatma, Parveshwara, Nishkalam Sarvakarana Karanam, that Brahman. That is Nirdesha, that is Nirdishta, that is told, defined as three, Om, Tat and Sat. Iti Bhagavad Bhajanat.
So the meaning of the word Brahma itself is to expand.
If
we say Brahmanda,
I get what you are saying. The word Brahman, Brihattamatvat Brahma.
Yeah.
So when you define the word Brahma, you dissect that word Brahma.
Mm-hmm.
Now what is the word being defined here? Tat.
Mm-hmm.
What is he writing commentary upon?
Tat.
So tanoti iti tat Brahma. So the focus is on?
Tat.
Yeah. Both are the meanings are same.
Mm-hmm.
But the focus is not on the sound Brahma here.
Okay.
The focus is on the sound tat. Because these are mantras. Each time we focus on one mantra. Tasmai namaha. That is the focus now. The next one is Padam Anuttamam. What is the next one? Padam Anuttamam. See, Shankara writes in the end of the word, Savisheshanam idam ekam nama padam anuttamam iti. He says, don't take padam anuttamam as two different words. That is one ekam nama. That is why I read it together. Otherwise, you can say padam anuttamam. But it is not like that. For Shankara, he says, Pada Anuttamaya Namaha. I like that. He has to combine it. What is the meaning of Padam? Padyate, to step. Take a step. Padyate means? Take a step. Take a step means what? Walk. Take a step means what? Walk. That's why he says, Padyate, Gamyate. Padyate means going. Taking one step. Gamyate, to go. And we always say that in Sanskrit, Gatyarthaganam Jnanarthagatvam. Whenever you say Gati, it means Nyaptihi, it also means no. Did it go? Did it go means what? Did you understand? So whenever you say Gati, Jnanam is also understood. Here, so Mumukshubihi, by the Mumukshubihi, Jnayate, Padyate, they go means what? Where can they go? Everywhere there is Vishnu. So here going means what? Knowing. Gamyate means what? Jnayate. Who knows? Who have Icha? Who have Icha? A person who has Icha for knowing Vishnu is called Mumukshu. There are two kinds of Icha. One is Chikirsha. Chikirsha means I want to cook. Kartum Icha. I want to go. I want to know. All that desires you have. That is called as Chikirsha. And the opposite of that is called I want to retire. Mumuksha means I want to be free from this life of doing. That is so only those people who are after Mumuksha, who want to free. Padyate. Why only mumukshus? Because anuttamam. Mumukshus never compromise. They don't settle for anything less. They don't want to stop with swarga. Because you have to come back. So they want to go to such a place, nasapunaravartate, from where you don't come back. You don't want a place where you have to come back. That is why mumukshubihi. Yet padam, that padam is always anuttamam. What is anuttamam? Yasmad uttamam nasti. Uttamam means superior, superlative. Nothing is greater than this uttamam. That is why it is anuttamam. Na uttamam. Yasmad. He writes that, Yasmad utkrishtam nasti. Tat anuttamam. Yasmad utkrishtam nasti. Than which there is nothing superior. Hence it is called anuttamam. What is that anuttamam? Padam. Jnanam. Or sthanam. Padam means sthanam. Where everybody gamyate. It is not really sthanam. Where it is away. It is not in Mecca or Medina or Vaikunda or Kailasa. It is right here in your hridaya. By knowing. That is what that pada, the step you take is just knowing. And that sthanam of Vishnu of padam is utkrishtam. Vishnor yat paramam padam sada pashyanti surayaha. Surayaha, the muktas. Suri means muktas, nitya suris. They always see it. That is called the anuttamam padam.
This is like the muktanam paramagati.
Yeah, that is the destination.
Yeah.
Here it is. Gamya sthanam, destination. Yeah. Sthanam. Yeah. Estate. When you say sthanam, destination, you think of Florida or some place. But here what he means is state of consciousness. It's not away from you. You becoming, you recognizing that. That is why you don't go anywhere to do this. You just know it. By his kripa, of course. By his kripa. That is why he is that padam. Because he is that padam, he can give it to you. Savisheshanam idam ekam nama padam anuttamam iti. This is ekam nama. Don't take it as padam anuttamam. Padam anuttamam iti ekam nama. Savisheshanam. Savisheshanam means qualifying, adjective. So, padam is the noun, anuttam is the qualifier, anuttam is the adjective. That sthanam which has nothing superior to it. No other sthanam can be better than that. So, that anuttamam qualifies this visheshanam for this visheshya, which is padam. So, there is visheshana visheshya bhava between these two. That's what he says. Padamanuttamam. The next one is Lokabandhu. So why is it that he wants to give you this padam to you? What is his interest in you? Why when you have two laddu, generally you give the smaller laddu to others. The big laddu, you keep it last. You finish off everything and put it in the last. This is the general habit. If he is not your bandhu, but if he is your best friend, then you give the bigger laddu to him, you take the smaller laddu. That is what Vishnu is doing actually. Loka bandhu means lokanam janakatvat, because he is the father. Who is Vishnu? Aham bija pradapita. So he is full of love for his creation. So among siblings, you will take the bigger laddu. But if it is a bandhu, then you offer the big chunk. That is why he is giving the uttamam padam. The best thing is reserved for you. Why? Because he is your janaka. That is filial affection. That makes him give you the uttamam padam. Of course, if you are a mumukshu, if you think that it is just a rock, then he won't have anything to do with you. But if you are a mumukshu, he wants to give you the best. Why? Because he is bandhu. He is lokabandhu. That is the reason. First, he gives the paramarthika meaning, the philosophical meaning. What is the philosophical meaning? Adharabhute asmin sakalaha lokaha badhyante. Even the space of the entire universe is sitting on consciousness, on awareness. So that's where Vidhyante, everything is tied upon. He is the foundation for the entire structure. Hence he is Lokabandhu. So the first meaning of Lokabandhu is where everything is Bandhita, where everything has been tied up. The second meaning is Lokanam Janakatvat Bandhu. Because he is the father of the entire world. Vishnu is the Janaka. So Janakopamaha. Upamaha means compared to. Just like your father. Your father will give you the best and he will go hungry. Tadupamaha bandhu nasti. There is no one like a parent. There is no one like a parent who would give anything to you. That is why he wants to give uttamam padam to you. Because he is your janaka. And why he is loka bandhu? Because he is lokanathaha. Then is the next one. Lokanam bandhu krityam. Hita ahita upadesham. Shruti smriti lakshanam kritavan. Itiva Lokabandhu. Oh, not Lokanathaha yet. third meaning for Loka Bandhu. The first meaning was Badnadi, one who is the substratum. Second meaning was Janakaha, he was a father. The third meaning is really he is your relative. He is not your Janaka, but he is your... Who is a true relative? They say, Bandhuschet Analayana Kim. If you have a relative, there is no need of any fire. It is just a way of saying. But here Shankara writes, Bandhu Grityam Karodi Idi Bandhu. A person, a true relative is a person who binds you, binds the entire family. Some people are there, women when get they married into families, there will be several bahu, but there is one bahu who will really bind the entire thing. So everybody will be looking to be with them because they are the tying force. They sacrifice their time. They think about others. So that is the bandhu krityam. What is a true bandhu krityam? Not analaha. Not being a fire, but being hita ahita upadesham. One who thinks about what is hitam, what is well-being for the entire clan. Ahitam, what is to be avoided, that also she should think. Why I am saying she? Because in my experience, that is what happens. So that is a true bandhu. A true bandhu is a person who thinks about the hitam and ahitam. That's what Shankara writes. Lokanam bandhu krityam. In this world, in this transactional world, lokanam bandhu krityam, hita ahita karanam. So that is the general bandhu. How is Vishnu called bandhu? What hitam did you do to you? And what ahitam Vishnu did to you? He did hitam by creating Shruti and Smriti. What did Vishnu do? By becoming Vyasa, by taking the incarnation of Vyasa, he divided the Vedas and he created the Smritis. That is the hitam he did. That is why Vishnu is your bandhu. So first he said, who is a bandhu? A bandhu who takes care of your well-being. And Vishnu is a bandhu because he took care of your well-being by creating this Smriti and Shruti. What is a Shruti and Smriti? Do good, resist from bad. Ramavat Vartitavyam na Ravanavat. That is Hita Ahitam. Hence he is called Loka Banduhu. So Lokanam Bandhukrityam Hita Ahita Upadesham Shruti Smriti Lakshanam Kritavan. Iti Vishnuhu Loka Banduhu. Susti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahim Mahisha Go Brahmane Bhishubhamasya Nityam Loka samasta sukino bhavantu, sarve bhavantu sukinaha, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadrani vashyantu, ma kaschid dukkha bhag bhavet, om shanti shanti shanti.